Welcome, everyone, to Unity on the Lakeshore. Let us now stand and join in song with Amy and Jesse. In our morning prayer.
Close our eyes, get comfortable, and pray for love, understanding, and faith. And as we develop that today, in everything we do, we want to carry that forth through the week. And as we cross the country with everyone believing in love, faith, and understanding, we can bring about a better world and all exist there together. Amen.
Amen. Oh, good morning, everyone. Glad to see you all here. I'm Roger Arbour, your host for today. I'm delighted to be with you. Let's give a hello to all of our online streamers as well. A friendly wave. And thanks to Amy and Jesse for their wonderful music. Unity on the Lakeshore is a non-denominational spiritual community anchored in loving acceptance. If you are here with us for the first time, please know that whoever you are or wherever you are on your spiritual journey, you are welcome here. At this time, I've asked John to light the Christ candle. You can read along with me as we make our statement about the Christ candle. It should be on the slide. We light the Christ candle, remembering the Christ in us. Now join me in speaking our vision statement. That's also up there on the slide. Every life, a spiritually transformed life. And now our affirmation of faith together. There is only one presence and one power, as me and as the universe, God the good, omnipotent. And now join us for our congregational song. For today, July 17th, is trust. I place my trust in God. Few things are greater comfort than the deep and abiding trust in God. When I trust, I move more confidently through life. I feel the wind at my back and am made strong in the face of adversity. In the past, I may have felt disappointed when I misplaced my trust. The things of the world are impermanent. Even people come and go. The truth of God as the one presence and power in the universe and as my life is everlasting, unchanged and unchanging through all the seasons of life. Even as I grow, evolve, and deepen in spiritual understanding, God is always my source, the inspiration I return to again and again. My freedom to seek and discover lies in the awareness that I can always trust in God. And from Isaiah 26:4, trust in the Lord forever, for in the Lord God you have an everlasting rock. Now Barbara Corcoran will lead us in meditation.
If we can all close our eyes and begin to breathe deeply, in and to a count of four out. In, two, three, four, out. as we begin to relax, bring the light into your crown chakra. And allow that light to journey down your body to your heart. Focus and listen to your heart beating. Try to feel the cadence of your heart, the flow of your life. Your heart brings you love, understanding, kindness. Through our heart, we can develop trust and understanding. Let's just rest there a second. As we rest, we know there is nothing but love. Love for our fellow neighbors, friends, strangers, anyone that we meet through our path in life. We understand we're all different, yet we're all the same. Remember the passing thoughts that you're having and try to bring them with you or return at a later date and catch up with those feelings. Bring the light up through your body, out the crown, and when you're ready, open your eyes and join us again. Jesse, another song.
Burn up the interstate, got somewhere you need to be. You're not gonna let nobody slow you down. Turn off the radio, turn up your telephone. Don't have the time to smell the roses now. Just take a second maybe before it gets too late.
Today, we welcome our guest speaker, Laurel Donnellan. Laurel is a founder, CEO, and podcaster at Compassionate Leaders Circle and contributor at Forbes.com. Laurel is a new member here at Unity on the Lakeshore, and we'll talk how finding and expressing your personal passions can lead to becoming more compassionate to yourselves and others. Let's welcome Laurel.
It's such an honor to be here, and I am so delighted that I get to talk about something I'm passionate about. I'm looking at today as a bridge from what Mark Anthony talked to us last week about passion and expression and the sacral chakra. I have a resume that has a lot of things on it, but the two things that aren't on my resume are dream doula, which is really what I am, and friend, which I'm really passionate about being a great friend. And I believe that it's very hard to be on the planet right now, and there is a way to happiness and presence and more peace, and I believe that path is through personal passion. I also believe that this world is compassionate, and people are compassionate, animals are compassionate, and to find that potential is also through things like what we do every Sunday here, is getting quiet and getting clear about who we are. The Dalai Lama has said, love and compassion are necessities, not luxuries. In fact, humanity cannot survive without them. And I have been a student of compassion and passion for the last 30 years. And so I know some things about those two topics, but I still have a lot to learn. The words compassion and passion come from suffering, and that's the lineage and the root of the word, passion. We've talked about the passion of Christ in the Bible. But fortunately, those ideas have evolved and are actually more about joy than they are about suffering. So when we work with the idea of compassion, we use the definition, compassion is preventing or alleviating suffering. So you can prevent suffering on the planet by recycling, doing something really small, or you might be an environmentalist that can figure out how to save us from forest fires and climate change. Compassion is something I didn't choose as a path, it chose me because of some suffering. So the two most significant events in my life, one happened at 3 and one happened when I was 54. I'm 62 now. When I was 3, my mother lost a baby, so I lost a brother. And that brought a lot of grief and suffering to her and to my family. And when I was 3 years old, I lost my mother for about a year to a mental hospital. She came back and she healed, and she was part of our family again. When I was 54, I got a PhD in compassion because I lost a sister. And I really learned about other people alleviating my suffering. And I spent 6 months in ICUs, rehabs. My sister had heart disease, and I learned that there's angels walking around in every community, and they're called ICU nurses. And they really know and are really practicing God's work on this planet. So they taught me about compassion. And as compassion is part of my profession, I've also had to nerd out on compassion and read a lot about compassion and understand compassion. And one of the ways that I understand it is there's sympathy, which is more about thoughts. Like, we can have thoughts about the people in Ukraine that we don't know and feel sorrow for them. And that's beautiful. Then there's empathy. Empathy is sharing feelings, right? So the other day, I had a conversation with a Liberian refugee, and I was interviewing her for Forbes, and we cried through the whole interview. And I heard her story of walking from Liberia to the Ivory Coast with her father and what she saw. And so I really felt, even though I've never experienced being a refugee, I really felt her pain. And that's empathy, and that's really beautiful too. Compassion, the way that we define it at my company and with people that we work with, is those thoughts, feelings, plus action. So compassion is about preventing or alleviating suffering through action, by doing something, right? So 2 weeks from now, I'm going to be working with students from all around the world, and we're doing a world service project. We're actually creating packages to send to Ukrainian children in Europe. That's doing something. And there's actually a lot of research now about how compassion and doing something with your passion is actually better for your health than empathy. Because empathy, feeling other people's feelings, you can actually get stuck in that. But if you do something about it, the energy moves, and it's actually better for your health. So, you know, again, sympathy, empathy, compassion, they're all really good, but doing something, if it's a little action like recycling or a big action like changing the world, can actually be good for your health. So compassion is preventing or alleviating suffering. Passion, which is part of the word, is really about love. It's about loving a person, maybe a place. My newest passion is Western Michigan. I'm all about it. Like the cherries, the landscape, the sand dunes, the beaches. I'm so in love. Passions can be about other things, right? So when I work with people as their dream doula, we kind of dive into identifying and developing passions. And no matter what age we're at, I've worked with people from 5 to 78, and my 78-year-old started a new business. We have to ask ourselves, is this a passion or a pattern? Because sometimes we get stuck in the way we are. I have a mentor that says, God is the only one that can say, that's just who I am. That's just the way I am. So we have to look at our activities, our interests. So we delve really deeply into, what are you curious about? What do you not know that you want to learn? What are your talents? So talents are different than skills. Talents are those things that give you energy back. And once we get to a certain age, there's a lot of things that we do that we'd be happy to delegate. Like, if I could have a whole accounting department and do none of my bookkeeping, I'd be very happy. But I wouldn't want to delegate speaking or teaching. That's a real talent that I have that gives me energy back. So you want to think about, what are those things that I'm doing that drain me? What are those things that I'm doing that energize me? Then there's environment. What are those things that you need to have in your home or in your community or on vacation that energize you? Some people like chaos. Some people like stuff. Some people like sitting under a tree. We're all different. So what is the environment that energizes you? And then it's style. When I work with people around livelihood, I always tell people, if you love to swear, find a job where you can swear. Because you don't want to be a different person in life and at work. You want to be the same person. Some people like to dress up. Some people like to wear Birkenstocks and shorts. Some people, you know, like to bring spirituality into their work. I've been lucky enough to be able to do that. Some people rather do other things, have a different style, have a more formal style, want to have a corner office and wear suits. And those are all good things. So asking yourself, what is your style, is also about passion. Where do you get your energy around passion? So I believe that if people spent more time figuring out what they're really passionate about and how to express it, we'd have more compassion in the world and people would be more aligned because they would be themselves and they would be expressing their passions through service. And I have some stories about that. I've had the privilege of hearing people's secrets and helping them make those secrets into reality. I've been doing it for 30 years, and I have permission to tell these stories of real people. By the way, when we talk about compassion, there's really three ways to express compassion, and to me, they're all equally as important. I think sometimes in churches or in the world, we think of compassion for others as the best type of compassion, but self-compassion is just as important, and sometimes we need to be focusing on ourselves, right? So there's self-compassion, there's vulnerability, so that's like taking risks and sharing what's really going on. If I didn't share with my friends my journey with my sister every day, I would have not survived it, right? So when you're vulnerable, you're allowing other people to be compassionate. So there's self-compassion, self-care, there's vulnerability, and then there's being of service to others and compassion for others. And I have three stories from people I've been able to work with that demonstrate all three as a path to more compassion. So the first story is about one of my very first clients. His name is Casey. He lives in New York City now. He's an interior designer, an actor, a painter, many, many things. When I met him, he was a waiter. And I was like, I don't think you're a waiter. I think you're an artist. And he remembers this story. He actually showed me this recently. He said, you made me get a card that said artist. And really by focusing on himself and his own spiritual journey, he slowly but surely was able to put his art into the world and create a more compassionate world. And he does that every day through his art. And his journey was more about self-compassion and believing in himself. The second story is about Karen. All three of these stories' names begin with K, but that was a synchronicity. Karen was the executive director of one of the oldest and most interesting not-for-profits in the country. It's called Harlem Dowling. It was started as the first orphanage in New York that took on brown and black children over 100 years ago. And so she had a life of service, but she had a secret. And her secret is around vulnerability. So when I worked with her, she shared poetry that she had written and never shared with anyone. And she shared it with me. And we helped her publish her book of poetry. And soon after that, unfortunately, Karen was diagnosed with breast cancer and did not survive that. But her children have her book of poetry. And she was able to share that with them. And they actually gave out poetry at her funeral, her books. So that's an example of how vulnerability turns into compassion. And then my last story is about Catherine, who had a dream of being an artist and thought she wanted to be an artist. She was a big, giant business person in big media companies, and she thought that a quiet life at a potter's wheel would be her thing. But then she realized she needed to integrate her business chops with art. And so she created a beautiful store, an online store called Amano, and she helps artists. So she curates other people's art, mostly in Brooklyn, and helps them with the business part of art, and has been able to integrate her business experience with her art experience, and now she's getting all this beautiful art out into the world and helping artists that are sometimes not the best business people to create art. And so she has an amazing staff. She helps artists. She's helping her community. This little bit of an idea turned into a lot of compassion and a lot of healing for the world, really. So there's many ways to find and follow passions, but I do believe it's the path to more compassion. I believe that now and in all times when it's hard maybe to be present with what's going on with the world and be peaceful about it, if you can find something, some way for you to express what you love and connect it to healing, healing yourself, being more vulnerable, or being of service to others, you can find more peace through passion. So that's the passion and compassion. I'd like you to think about this week as you go forward, what you can do to know yourself, to find passions. Ask yourself, is this a pattern or a passion? I have a friend who's like a sports nut and watches sports all the time. And during COVID, I was like, are you missing sports? He goes, not at all. I think it was a pattern, not a passion. So ask yourself, what's a pattern, what's a passion? Sometimes finding passions is going back to your history. So I've done two things this year that make me feel 10 years younger. One is skiing. I thought I'd never ski again. And I went skiing with my brother and sister at the place we learned to ski, and our goal was not to get hurt. All three of us did it. And then a few weeks ago, I took a tennis lesson. And so sometimes it's like going back to things that you've done when you were younger and connecting to that. Sometimes it's finding new things. Like, I moved here and I'd never been here before, and I love Western Michigan, and I love Unity. I love you all. So happy to be here. Thank you for your time, and we're going to do a prayer now. And I'm going to use some artistic license here and take what the Dalai Lama says, but add a little bit more to it. Love, passion, and compassion are necessities, not luxuries. Mother, Father, God, Great Spirit, thank you for this time. Thank you for this place, and thank you for these people. Open their hearts to more self-compassion and vulnerability and passion for others. Help them have happiness and health. Help them open their hearts a little bit more to receiving more love. Om Atakwiasin, amen.
Thank you, Laurel. That was a great, great inspirational talk from you. I think you're talking about compassion and passion. In there, you mentioned love also is important. I'd like to quote a Unity minister from Florida who has it all down pat. He says, love is the answer. What's the question? I like that. Okay, now's the time we can share our passion for giving to this, to our church and Unity. If the ushers would come forward. Let's join together in our offertory statement. Divine love, through me, blesses and multiplies
all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. I am grateful.
There are a number of ways you can give, besides from putting whatever blessing you'd like to in the basket today. We also have an option to give through text. You send the word give to the number 616-236-5205. That's give to 616-236-5205. If it is your first time giving this way, you will receive a link with instructions on how to do that. If you've given before through text, then all you simply have to do is text a dollar amount to that number, and it automatically goes right to the church. You can also give online through our website at unityonthelakeshore.org/donations. For those watching online, the link is in the chat. You can also mail a check to Unity on the Lakeshore, P.O. Box 848, Douglas, Michigan, 49406. We now have another song by Amy and Jesse.
Unity Lakeshore, we are so blessed to be here with you today. Please sing along with the song.
I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed. I am so blessed.
If you're in need of support, there are a few ways to receive that. First is to email us at unitylakeshore@gmail.com. You can also phone the office here, 269-857-8226. And there is always Unity, Silent Unity, in Kansas City. That line is open 24/7 at 816-969-200. Wednesday evening is prayer and meditation at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. This is a new time for the summer. It is held on Zoom. The Zoom link is on our website, Facebook page, and in our newsletter. Please join us. Now, Barb, would you like to say a few things about the new book study we're starting this coming Tuesday?
Hi. We're going to have a book study on the three essays of universal law, the laws of karma, will, and love. And I have a couple books if someone would like to buy it. If not, they're $8.95. You can get them on Amazon. And we'll have it for 3 weeks, I think. It says four on the on flyer, but I think it's really only going to be three because there's three parts to it. So welcome everybody and anybody, and you don't have to come to the first one to come to the second one or the third one. You can show up anytime. And you're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you, Barb. Any other announcements? Anyone on the floor? Okay, well, we have a save the date here for August 27th. Unity is hosting a community-wide summer dance party, which will be fun right here on our property. We will have music from a DJ, Ruth Crow. The first hour will be swing dancing with lessons, and then the rest of the evening will be familiar tunes that we can all dance to. There will be food and beverage provided. Tickets are $20 and will include one of my burgers or hot dogs. We're going to have hot dogs also. And I think I'll have enough. You can have more than one if you really haven't eaten all day. And we have chips and a beverage. Tickets will be available for purchase next Sunday. Once officially announced, we'll ask you to spread the word. This will be a fun community event. If you haven't liked our Facebook page, please do so. This is a way you can share about all the great things going on here and engage with others. You can find us at facebook.com/unitylakeshore. Are there any first-time guests here? I didn't notice anyone, so just welcome everyone. Now is the time for our closing. Let there be peace on earth. Please feel free to stand or remain seated.
Unity Lakeshore, mwah, that's a wrap, at least for this Sunday. Thank you so much for having us. Let's join together in our closing tune.
Be my joyous vibe.